and I'm a much stronger runner now.
Is it time to swap over?
I've got
you're swapping up. Are you
swapping? I've only done 11 minutes.
Oh, okay. No, that's fine. Yes. No?
Still another 4,
I think. No. Yeah.
I like to do the high, because like the running's all good and that, but the high intensity stuff is good as well, isn't it? So
yeah.
I have to build my outdoor running. I'm going to try and lose another half a stone in 4 weeks. And I'll be down to 15.
You're definitely looking lighter than I was.
Yeah, been for a long time,
yeah. For a while, yeah.
Yeah. But I mean, I'm 16 and a half now.
What's the sensible weight for you?
Wow, well, I was, before I was here, I was 14. So.
Oh, right.
So, but that seems quite light now, though.
Woodbridge.
Yeah, I was 14, 90 kilos. But that's... I don't think I'll be. I don't know if I'll get down to that low.
No, but you need something that's manageable, something you can maintain.
I think 15. I was looking at the actuals. I was looking at the boxes because David Hay's about the same size as me, isn't he? He's 6'3". But he looks short, doesn't he? But he's not. He's quite tall. He's my size. But he's I think he weighed in at 15 stone, 96 kilos. And he looked, well, he obviously looked really ripped, didn't he? But he's not.
Yeah, because that's the other thing as well. If you've perhaps got a little bit more.
Yeah, I don't think going below 15 would be good for me. I think 15 is the very lowest, I think. Because I'm never going to be built like a runner anyway. I mean.
No, you're not. That's not your genetic makeup.
No, I'm never really going to be, unless I just go hyper on just the running and do the mileage. And,
yeah.
But I don't think I'll get that
it's
small.
It's not good for you though, Dan, either.
Yeah, I don't think I'll get that small.
Yeah. What? We're
going to set up a
couch. This is
directly
under
the...
Got ones
in there
too? Yeah. Cool. You can see
them. Yeah.
It's directly
under, so that's not... Yeah, I feel it. Oh.
Is that still Lee?
Yeah. Both sides. Is that the same place?
Really?
Yeah.
What did you say? You've been doing squats and...
Well, yeah.
Oh,
yeah, squats.
I feel that.
What's that
knot there?
It's a big one.
It's
kind of
fair
enough.
Oh, blimey. Oh, blimey,
yeah.
Massive.
Do you know much about the new gym that's
opening
up
this day?
You know the guy?
Yeah, I know the guy. He's one of my old students.
Oh, is he?
Martin, yeah. I was going to ask you that earlier. How's everyone coping now? Because it's a better gym, isn't it? Apparently.
I obviously don't know, Dan. I don't even...
It's a much better gym. He's got a good... He's done a lot of research. He's done... He's got...
He's put his house in it, isn't he?
Has he? Yeah, he's gone for it. But he He's got, I think he's got it right though. He's got. I think the balance. I've been in there when he's building it. I've had a meeting with him, and he's got a functional training area, a big functional training area. He's got a separate weights area and the cardio. He's got a second. He's divided it into two. He's got a second entrance for just dance because his girlfriend does dance. So you've got the females that just want to do the dance. They don't have to go through the gym. They can go the other side. He knows about the gym anyway, because he was telling me about DW, and he was talking about the ambience and the lighting, and so he knows all that stuff. And I heard he'd done an open day on a Saturday. He signed up 300 people in one day.
Where's that though?
There's a new gym opening up at the Stone Market near the station.
Okay.
There's one of my students, or my ex-students, he's got in and They've got a few thousand. I think he's reached almost 1,000 now members. So he's done really well.
I haven't seen any major drop off. I don't know any of the figures that might happen. Because he is a close friend of mine, her brother, and business. Yeah,
and they fell out, didn't they?
Yeah, I don't know the ins and outs.
They fell out, they used to own Body Wise.
Yeah, and Andre still does.
Yeah, yeah.
But I don't need to know the ins and outs, but you know, that's... Yeah. You know,
that's the only problem. I think I don't know if he's in business with his girlfriend. It's the only fault. I've done that as well. Going to business with a partner.
You're
Sorry.
Martin Andre. Is that who's over that new job?
No, Martin Beasley.
Oh. Andre was his business partner.
Yeah.
Because
he's out with Sarah, isn't he? Married to Sarah.
Sarah who?
He's married her later this year.
Yeah. I don't know.
So do you know Andre's sister, Mirai?
No, okay. I only know Sarah because she used to work at the YMCA.
Oh right.
But I've done a few courses with Martin, which was his ex-business partner.
Yeah.
So it's only trouble when you fall out and you're in business together.
Oh, yeah.
That's why it's best to just go on your own.
Yeah, so I knew they'd had a little bit of a falling out and what have you, but... No, I know he's, it's Colted Stone Leisure Centre to spend £1,140 on new spin bikes. But they are decent, I've got to say.
Are they the same as the ones at Witten?
Sorry?
Are they the same as the ones at Witten?
They are the same ones that David George is currently, beginning with Kays at Kaiser.
But that's what happened with Witten Sports Centre when all these new gyms opened up, they spent thousands.
Really?
Yeah, I've heard he's doing really well, but he has got the right idea.
Yeah.
Because gyms will start to be moving towards more
being more functional. You know, for me, it was just like when he put his
house
against his house and all that.
Yeah, because he did seem stressed, like when he was doing it. Well, he's quite stressed. I was surprised because he's quite a stressed person, really. He's quite nervous.
It's the very first year of
it's been a tough
time, isn't it?
Then
you can do this. There? Yeah, everywhere around there.
Is that okay?
Yeah. No? Right, doing the tender.
Tender? Tender there?
Yeah, all around there.
Oh, I'm going to beat it instead. Can't beat it. Is that better?
Yeah, that's
too hard or not?
No, it's fine
This bit's like boxing anyway.
Yeah.
It's pretty bad.
It is. I've got my PT session next week. She said, oh, I need to do running. I said, right, can I make a request then? Because if I have to do something really horrible, it's like, I have to do something. And she knew what I was going to say to me. And I said, can I do some boxing again? I love it. I mean, that's just using pads, but I love it.
It's I think it's the hardest, one of the hardest.
Oh, God, Dad, my arms are fit to drop the next day.
When you do it properly, like when I did it with Steve in that gym. And you've got to keep your guard up, and you've got to keep your hands up when you kick, and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, unbelievable. She makes me keep my shoulder
as well. Yeah. You do that and move around, and. Yeah.
I do. So she's like, fair enough. She said, we can do that first, that'll be the better bit, and then you've got to go around and do
intervals
running.
Yeah. The girls that are on my course, though, they're amazing. Like, their flexibility is unbelievable. They're like doing the splits and all this.
Oh, really?
They can kick.
High, yeah.
Yeah.
Because they've got that flexibility.
Yeah. They've got a real good thing going down there. Their women's classes are so popular. We've got women-only classes for kickboxing and stuff. And I met some of them when I was down there.
Is it Dawson, is it?
Yeah, I met some when I was down there. One girl lost 3 stone.
Oh, really?
Yeah, just for purely boxing.
So I've got to be honest, I'm not convinced that that's working for me today.
Cold.
We've switched that from 18 to 23, and there's no difference in my opinion.
I feel hot.
Do you?
Yeah.
And even the first time we were in, I put it up to 21, and that was getting.
They did have it fixed. I will say something. Okay. That one's moving, isn't it?
I'm sat right underneath this one of these.
Mm. with me, Sully? Is the was the pounding better than the
yeah
frictions and the yeah?
Yeah. Donald, head up, come to my car.
I wouldn't go so far as put my house in. I mean, that's a big gamble.
No, I think that is a gamble. That's a risky venture. But, you know, right, that's his choice, isn't it? But I know I wouldn't.
Yeah, I don't know how actually, how that all works in terms of rent and bills and utilities. Quite a few overheads, isn't there?
Yeah.
Staff.
Yeah, because he took Julie Zarkos from, well, he didn't take her, she left the leisure centre, few of the leisure centre staff on over to him, I think.
All right.
So I think that's where
they
have lost a couple of bits.
They almost certainly will be, but then I suppose...
Yeah. Oh, it's inevitable, Dan.
I suppose that when they get new bits and bobs in, they'll get certain people. And it will suit certain people to be just with them anyway.
And then sometimes the grass isn't always greener, so those staff come back and, you know, you just...
But I mean, this is the thing I was always writing about anyway because of my courses and stuff, but the industry's growing a hell of a lot. There's a new gym, I've just heard that the Berry Gym, the Abercroft, they've...
I don't know.
They're the one in Felixstowe.
Alright.
And I'm like, it's small.
Yeah.
It's got two gyms, you think that would serve the whole of Felixstowe, but they're the one in Felixstowe. So it's massive, it's a massive industry. There was 163 gyms opened up in the UK last year.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's massive. It's
crazy.
Absolutely.
But it was good, really.
This which has got loads of gyms there. A lot of choice now, though, as well as lots of choice. In Watford, I know in Watford they've opened a new 24-hour gym. Just everywhere, yeah. Everywhere. Whereas I've missed one too around here, right?
It's amazing how we're supposed to be in a 24-hour society, yet a lot of the time it isn't 24-hour, is it?
Yeah. I can't understand that. You right?
Yeah.
I can't understand... 24-hour gyms, I can't see where you want to work out.
It'll be shift workers, won't it?
Yeah, it is a shift worker.
Yeah, it'll be shift workers that will go in at all hours. That's better. Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong,
too much?
No, I'm sorry.
You sure?
Yeah.
He's a man of steel, isn't he? See if you can do that same thing as you can on the outside.
Yeah.
That level of pressure is too high. I need to ease off and just do a little bit less. It's fine.
So when
you give that to a customer and they go out, then you stop. No, you haven't.
Most nights I trip, I'll get just, and again, you keep asking them. It's all about communication. And I'll go, I'll be working away, and I'll go, is that all right? And they'll go, yeah. And I'll go, I might say, I'll bring tea. And you go again, and you're like, is that all right? I said, is it getting unbearable? It's going to get unbearable. And that was unbearable. But no, because that's how it is. And then you gauge where the depth at which you can go. There's nothing wrong with that at all. But as long as you ease off.
Yeah. Is there a
whereas if you keep going on that basis, that's when you'll jar a client off.
Right.
But if you ease off and respond to what they're telling you, then you're absolutely fine.
So when look, with Lee's got his soreness, I've gone into it, come out,
yeah.
Changed legs and stuff. But is there a point where you say, okay, we'll just leave that until next time?
Yeah.
And then say, yeah. And then work on it again.
Yeah.
Because I've gone into it two or three times now.
You can only tolerate so much on it, yeah.
So I've gone into it two or three times.
Yeah, that's right. But in fairness, that's the point I wanted you to get to today.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Was to get that pressure and find, do that. There's nothing wrong with that at all. The same as Sarah was trying to say, wasn't she? And I was like, no, this is fine,
I'm sorry.
You found the depth of pressure,
yeah?
And then you ease off.
Right. Yeah. So sore.
And know where that the limit is.
Too much?
A little bit.
Ease off.
He's having a ball over there.
They're set at the same place, aren't they?
You can see how red it is.
So on the lateral side of my calf, both sides, pretty much the same place.
A lot of people have lateral gastroc trigger points.
Yeah.
It's quite common. It'll either be lateral or medial. But a lot of it is a common area, lateral gastroc. You've definitely got this potent,
Alright?
Yeah, it was good.
It was a little bit less severe, wasn't it?
You're getting more puffy than anybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's less
slashing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's more puffy. Yeah. Yeah. You've got, I'd say, you've
probably
got the best of that one.
Yeah.
Yes. Sensitive, yeah?
Yeah, very.
So I think you've got your spine covered.
You can see on both your legs.
It's matched up, I reckon, aren't
they? They're both red, yeah. There you go, mate.
Love it. I should get a walk.
And that does generate.
Almost at the same place, isn't it?
Exactly the same place, yeah.
Really good
answers. Mm-hmm. Didn't get too big.